And we call it the iPad. And what this device does is extraordinary. It's unbelievably great, way better than a laptop.
Steve Jobs said those words 9 years ago when he introduced the original iPad. And for the past 9 years, that hasn't really been true. iPads have always been limited, and you could do so much more with a laptop. But now, in 2019, Steve Jobs' statement is finally coming true. This is all due to the combination of two things. The extremely powerful and capable iPad Pro that is finally equipped with a USB-C port, and the upcoming release of iPadOS, Apple's brand new operating system that's exclusively for iPads, adding a lot of computer-like functionality. These two things together are able to satisfy the most common computer needs that people have today, and as you'll see in a minute, the iPad Pro packs a ton of performance and in some ways, offers even more than you can get with a MacBook. We currently have a couple of options when looking for a lower-end premium Apple computer. We've got the 2018 iPad Pro, starting at $800 for the 11-inch or $1,000 for the 12.9-inch. We've also got the 2019 MacBook Air for $1,100 and the 2019 13-inch MacBook Pro for $1,300. And this year's base MacBook Pro is a really great value for the cash, as you guys have probably seen in our recent Which MacBook Should You Buy video. But what's great about the iPad Pro is that even if you go all out and load up the larger 12.9-inch model with 256 gigs of storage, Apple's new and improved smart keyboard, and the second generation Apple Pencil, it still comes out cheaper than the 13-inch MacBook Pro with a matching 256 gigs of storage. And even better, if you don't need some of those things like the larger display, the Apple Pencil, or the smart keyboard, you can pick and choose exactly what you want and save even more cash. Now the point of this video is seeing if the iPad Pro can actually be a better choice for some people, instead of going for a more expensive MacBook, as well as seeing what advantages you get with either one. For starters, a lot of people think that MacBooks will perform better, because they're obviously much larger and thicker machines. So we ran Geekbench 4, a cross-platform benchmark that tests raw performance. And we found that the $800 iPad Pro performs better than both MacBooks in both single and multi-core tasks, which is absolutely incredible for the price. We then tested the graphics performance with Geekbench 4's metal test, and we were shocked to see that the iPad Pro got a higher score than even the $1,800 2019 MacBook Pro. And all these MacBooks came out very recently. The crazy thing to think about is that the iPad Pro is about to get even more powerful with the expected iPad Pro update coming this fall, which should be packing a new A13X mobile chip. And with having that much power packed into a thin and light device like the iPad Pro, it would definitely be a great idea to protect your investment with an incredibly affordable warranty from Upsy, our sponsor for this video. Upsy works with nationwide certified repair shops and helps buyers in the United States save up to 70% on a warranty compared to retailers. And you can buy it within 60 days after your iPad purchase or 45 days for smartphones. Upsy makes it incredibly easy to make a claim by having real people available on the phone 24/7, 365 days a year. And they store your receipt and all the info you'll need right in your Upsy account. You can use the link in the video description with the code MAXTECH today for 10% off your first warranty purchase. So back to the iPad Pro. Even with the 2018 model, it's definitely not a slouch compared to the MacBook. Yes, it does have only 4 GB of RAM compared to 8 GB or even 16 for an extra $200 on those lower end MacBooks. But iOS has always been optimized for low amounts of RAM, and basically every app out there still works flawlessly. We can easily see two major markets where the iPad Pro makes sense to buy instead of a laptop. And before we get into that, let's first discuss the perks of each, starting with the MacBook. Of course, you get a full built-in keyboard and a trackpad with full cursor support, so you get a more traditional and comfortable laptop feel. You also get an extra port on the MacBook, or 3 extra ports if you're willing to spend at least $1,800. And they're much faster ports as well, supporting Thunderbolt 3, so you can do much more with them. And the biggest advantage is macOS, which has a lot more flexibility. Multitasking is much better on macOS, and same with connecting and using external devices and drives. There's just so much more you can do with macOS, especially using full desktop productivity apps like Final Cut Pro, Lightroom, Xcode, and Photoshop. And finally, the speakers are quite a bit better. So here's a quick sound comparison so you can hear the differences.
Ha ha ha!
While the MacBook speakers are noticeably better, the iPad Pro is the only iPad to come with two speakers on each side, so you get true stereo sound. And now let's discuss the advantages of the iPad Pro. For starters, it's much more portable than any MacBook. It's smaller, thinner, and much lighter, so it's easy to carry around. Another perk is that you have the choice of buying a keyboard like Apple's Smart Keyboard Folio, which also acts as a protective case for both the back and the front of the iPad. And while the keys aren't as nice to type on, at least you don't have to worry about failed keys like with the butterfly keyboards on the Macs. And in the worst case scenario, if the Smart Keyboard somehow breaks, you can easily swap it out for a new one, or buy one of the many Bluetooth keyboard options like the Bridge Pro keyboard. Now that's something you can't do on a MacBook. And when you're not using the keyboard, you can easily flip it to the backside and use the iPad in tablet mode. And that's another benefit. You have a touchscreen display with the iPad that's very simple and intuitive to use, which currently isn't available on any Mac. And the iPad Pro's display is many, many times better than any MacBook display. You have higher pixel density for a sharper image. You have a brighter 600 nit display compared to 500 on the MacBook Pro, so you can actually watch HDR content. Not only that, but it's still just as color accurate with P3 wide color gamut support. And finally, it gets ProMotion technology, which dynamically adjusts the display's refresh rate between 24 and 120 Hz for super smooth animations and navigation, while every single Mac display is currently limited to 60 Hz. While the MacBooks get Touch ID for quick login and authentication, the iPad Pro now has Face ID, which is completely hidden in the bezels, so it's really convenient. Another advantage is that you can get an iPad Pro with LTE cellular service, allowing you to have internet, make calls, and text people while away from Wi-Fi. That's something that's not possible on a MacBook. The iPad Pro also gets a rear-facing camera, something that you obviously don't get on a MacBook. And not just any camera, it's a top-of-the-line camera from the latest iPhones with 12-megapixel photos and 4K video recording at 60fps. The iPad Pro also has a 7-megapixel front-facing camera that completely wipes the floor with the 720p camera on the MacBooks. Just check out this video and microphone comparison between them. This is a video and audio quality test on the 2019 MacBook Air. This is a video and audio quality test on the 2019 MacBook Pro. This is an audio and video quality test on the 2018 iPad Pro. One thing that you can't get on a MacBook is a stylus, and the Apple Pencil is the best out there. You can use it to draw, take notes, and quickly mark up documents and screenshots. And even with the incredible performance that you get on the iPad Pro, it's still rated for the same 10 hours of battery life. And that's with a battery that's twice as small as the one on the MacBook Pro. And since the 7-nanometer processor uses less power, you'll probably get even better battery life while doing power-demanding tasks like video editing. Even better, the iPad Pro is completely fanless, so you never have to worry about any fan noise at all. And finally, there's the new iPadOS, which adds a bunch of computer-like features like updated multitasking, new gestures, and automatic desktop mode in Safari. But the biggest advantage is having access to the iOS App Store. There are undoubtedly many, many times more apps on the iOS App Store compared to macOS, and most developers are continuing to make apps for iOS instead of macOS. You also have lots of alternatives for productivity apps like video and photo editing apps and much more. And if we take a look at gaming, there are countless amounts of games available on iOS, while the game selection on macOS is pretty much non-existent. With that said, here are the two major markets where it makes sense to buy an iPad Pro over a MacBook. The first major market is students, who I'm sure would much rather carry around a 1-pound iPad in their backpack instead of a much larger 3-pound MacBook. With the Apple Pencil, students can easily take notes, mark up documents, and easily share them with the iPad, which is a major benefit compared to a MacBook. And with the Smart Keyboard Folio, they can use it in class just like a laptop. And it's great because iPadOS has finally added full keyboard shortcut support for typing documents and using in Safari. iPadOS has also finally added local storage and external drive support, so they can easily hook up a flash drive and transfer their schoolwork and files to and from their iPad. Now, external storage support is definitely not as full-featured and flexible as on macOS, but it offers just enough functionality for what students need it for. There's also a high-quality rear-facing camera, so students can quickly and easily snap a photo of their professor's chalkboard or PowerPoint presentation slide for future studying. Not only that, but with external display mirroring support, a student could even connect their iPad Pro to a projector to present their slideshow to their class without having to use a laptop. And if they need the extra performance for certain productivity apps or games, the iPad Pro offers immense amounts of power. The display is also excellent and the speakers are good enough to stream Netflix or any other media they'd like. The iPad is basically going to become the new standard computer for students. And finally, the second major market for choosing an iPad Pro over a MacBook is the massive amount of people who just need a basic computer for common tasks. There are people who absolutely need a Mac for doing things like high-end video or photo editing, programming in Xcode and audio production in Logic Pro, but a good majority of people only do basic computer tasks like browsing the web, typing up and printing documents, transferring and storing files, using apps, and maybe even playing some games. And with Apple's upcoming iPadOS, the iPad Pro is gonna do all these things, and it's gonna do them well. And if you think about it, if you take a common person that might not be very familiar with technology, when they pick up an iPad Pro, it's gonna feel natural to them. The Touch UI is simple, and more importantly, it's very familiar, because it's the same thing they're used to on their iPhone or smartphone. Laptops like Apple's low-end MacBook Air have been the standard for common people who just need a basic reliable computer, and it still is even to this day, because the majority of people have no idea that with iPadOS, an iPad can now finally replace a laptop. So if this video has convinced you to save some cash by going with an iPad Pro instead of a MacBook, we'll leave links down below to the best sales on the 2018 iPad Pro. And don't forget to protect your investment with a warranty from Upsy. So if this video helped you out, make sure to tap that like button and click the circle above to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.